We're interested in how the human brain learns, and so to do that, we look to birds who learn how to sing. I'm Emily Mackevicius. I'm a fifth year in the Brain and Cognitive Science Department at MIT. So the specific bird we study is the zebra finch, and zebra finches learn their song from their father. So in a similar way to how people learn to speak, starting from babbling and then getting more and more complicated words and sentences, baby birds start off babbling and they hear a song from their father, and then through practice, they can learn to imitate their father's song. The first thing the bird is able to do is he develops a protosyllable. This is one syllable that he can repeat again and again. And then he can make different variations on this protosyllable. As the bird is singing, he's improvising on his song, and if something he does winds up sounding really good, then he'll wind up keeping that as his best copy of the song. Some of the brain regions that are involved in bird learning are also impaired in diseases like Parkinson's and Huntington's in humans. MIT is a really awesome place to do this type of work because people care beyond just their small world to collaborate with other scientists and to see how their work applies to the community as well. So the hope is that by studying these brain circuits and understanding them better, this could one day be translated to better treatment of these types of disorders. And so it's not just me and my own bird bubble, but it's connecting it to other types of neuroscience work and research.